So to square it up,
we need some marking equipment, chalk or soap or pencil. We need a tape measure. We need a big square. If you have a big square or a T-square, or you can even use just, you know, like a big square piece of paper, because you know that that's a square. That will work. I just need to start on one of these, and I use a long rule also. Could be a long folded up piece of paper. I sort of want to put this to the point where I know it covers up. See how I've covered up all the raggedy junk? And I'm kind of sort of parallel, which would be my sewing line. So I don't want to mark a line there because it might show. So I'm going to flip the ruler over, and then I can mark a line on this side of it a little bit. You could mark this with a pencil. We'll mark this and see how much of it shows and how much of it I can't even see. Because you kind of don't know until you've done it all. Looks like it marked pretty good. Let me get a pencil. Looks like some of this pale stuff I should mark with a pencil. Mark the full length, probably longer than your rule is. Now we want to find sort of a similar place on this side, but how do we know that we're square? So what we're going to do is choose like the biggest we think it can be and then measure it and see if we're parallel. So here we're at 12 and a quarter, and here we're at 12 and an eighth. Good grief, what an eye. 12 and a quarter, kick it up to there, okay. Drop your tools on the floor. And I know the orange didn't show, so I'm going to reinforce that with the pencil. And I would probably actually, whoa, see, I ran off the edge of the green here, so I'm going to sew a little bit inside that once I get there. I wasn't, whoops, I'll have to sew a quarter of an inch inside of that. That's okay. Now I think it's nice at this point to actually cut it. And I have a good eye, so I will cut it half an inch away from this. If you feel safer, you can mark another line a half an inch away. I have a pretty calibrated eyeball here. Looks better already. This one I'm cutting kind of like a quarter of an inch away because I knew I was running out of room down here in the green land. So now at least we know we have two parallel lines. And now you can either get out your square, or you can use, you know, a big piece of paper as a square. And it doesn't really matter where it is at this point. The point is just to get something that's square. See how there's a little pucker here? That means we should open up some of the stitching here. Let me run back and get a tool.
I'm just going to move you a little along.
Great. This is my favorite blunt needle kind of tool for ripping out basting thread. And that probably released it, which means my line is not square anymore. So I better check that. Yeah, see how it released it there. Now this is much wider than that other side, so I want to make the amount of black the same on both of these. So I'm just going to sort of line up the two sides and see, I'm not really fussy about the measuring because I really don't care. Neat. Now I want to put a band of something here. I have some more of this background fabric, which is just cut loose and kind of big. And the only trick with this is to make sure that it's square. It doesn't want to be skewed here. So you might take your square and make sure you're square to the world. And I'll just stitch this with one stitch and then fold it over. I can look back here, see I need, like if I have a half inch seam allowance, I know I'll cover that, so that's pretty normal. And do the same on the other side. Except that I don't know where that piece of fabric is. We were using it for five different things.
Oh, I think it's behind you on the table there.
Perfect, yes. And if you feel better about it, you can always make a line here of what to sew on. Up to you. Whatever suits you. This is a case where it might be appropriate to have the correct color thread on. Not 100% necessary, but probably recommended to switch to all black at this point. Because after we stitch and flip this and true it up, then we will sew the lining to it, and that should be done in black thread too. So we can probably go to a color thread where the bobbin actually matters. Okay, so here we are sewing the black end panels on. And I might give you velvet or something fancy for these end panels, or satin. Velvet is a little tricky that you don't want to iron it because it crushes, but sometimes crushed velvet looks cool. So now we have to get off of zigzag because we want to be straight. And make sure we sewed in the right place. Well, look, see, I've got a little bit of thread showing here, so it would be just as easy to sew a little closer in and cover that. Beautiful. Which is probably a smart reason why we put the line on the other end, right? Sharp. Beautiful. Now back to the table to true up these ends, because see how they are too big and hanging out, so we need to cut them off. We flip this over now, and this fabric seems to be behaving, but you could certainly iron it here to make it behave. And see how it's kind of crazy now, we have to true it up. And we know that we trued up the background piece, so we know that this piece is all good and square. So we'll just put some pins in and baste around the edge, and then we can cut that excess off. Once again, this basting, that's not too critical. And then we just trim off these edges, even with it's time to decide if you need to embellish it any further, like this sample one where I added the gold circles, which I can show you how to do, but I really think this one is pretty cool just by itself, and I'm just going to line it at this point and be happy with that. If you want to accent the piece with some circles, you can do that. I cut a piece of fabric, drew the circle on it from the pattern, with the machine stitched around the circle so I had a good clear line of where it was, and instead of clipping it, I hand sewed a basting stitch around the edge and sort of gathered it up in order to pull all the edges into the center at once. And these are actually stuffed a little bit, where I sewed part of the way around and left myself a little opening, put the stuffing in, and then closed the opening shut. And I think it's fun if the circles are crazy accent fabric, so I did include some very special pieces over here. You know, once in a while I've given you velvet or brocade or glitz, something really fancy crazy in several of these if you want to do the circles. Although that rainbow one sort of proved you don't necessarily always need the circle accent. It's whatever composition you want.